Guys, welcome back. Today basically I'll be showing you how to create a Docker Compose file for deploying your Node.js application along with setting up MongoDB instance. So this is a very simple process. If you are not aware about how to create a Docker file or what is Docker Compose, I'll recommend just at least read a little bit about it. I'll try to explain it in more depth, but if you have some prerequisite about knowledge about what Docker is and how the container works and what are the Docker images, it would be really helpful. But in meanwhile, if you don't know about all this, so I'll recommend you just pause the video and just read about what exactly is Docker and what is Docker container and Docker image and what Docker Compose does using this Docker image and Docker container. Then I'll think you will be good to go. Plus you should also know about what about Node.js and MongoDB. I am assuming that obviously you know about Node.js and MongoDB, then only you are trying to learn about how to containerize that. So yeah, so let's move forward. So I have this my simple Node.js project setup, which is this Docker project. I'll just open this, drag and open this in open this in terminal. So this is my terminal. So this is a simple project, nothing too fancy, and I'll open the project as well in the VS Code. You can use any editor of your choice, but here I'm using VS Code. Okay, so here this is the basic Docker application. So I just created this application using the Express generator. So if you don't know about Express generator, I'll show you what Express generator is. So this, just search about Express generator, and it just create a boilerplate code for your Node application, nothing much. So you can simply install it using npm -i-g for global and Express generator, just use -g so that it is installed globally. So this is the command, and once this is installed, you can simply, I'll show you one example here. So currently I'm in this application, so I have installed npm -i-g Express generator. Now what I need to do is Express and whatever name of project you want. So suppose it is dummy project I have written. So it has created, see, now if I'll show you, see, here is the dummy project created. Okay, so I've used this to create the Node.js boilerplate code. If you want, you can move along, and I'll have pushed this code into a Git repository, and on GitHub, it is in public repository. I'll share the link in the description. So yeah, so I'll remove this dummy project because this is of no use. Okay, so I'll show you what. And this is my basically the application in which my MongoDB and Node.js server is set up. So I have opened this in my VS Code. Here I'll show you the basic flow. Okay, so this is my db.json file. So here I've given all the configuration related to my MongoDB. So here I've created that URL in which my host name, which is here, is Mongo. My Mongo port is the default port, that is 127.0.1.7, and the DB name. So I have written it Docker test. You can write it anything. So that's just naming that you can just name it any DB name you want, whatever your name is. And apart from that, you can provide all the authentication as well, because generally DB has authentication. So you can also provide that authentication in this particular URL. So here, this is the simple method of Mongoose to connect to the particular URL. And here this URL would be passed, and that it'll show either it is, if there is in some error, it will show the error, and if it's connected successfully, it will console the message connected successfully. Now second thing is this, the app.js file, where this is the basic app setting, and nothing too fancy. So what happened is, I'll show you the main thing. So here this is the main npm start command. Npm start is used for starting the script. So this is this folder. So I'll show you what it's exactly is in this particular folder. So this is, so here we have imported all the DB file and the app file, and REST, we have started the Node.js server on port 3000. That's that. That is just the simple server and the MongoDB setup. So now what next we have to do is we have here you can see I have this AWS EC2 instance which I have already started and it's running. So what I'll do is, so that's if you don't know about how to start, how to launch an EC2 instance, you can mention that in comment. I'll create a separate video for that, but that's a very easy step. Just you need to have a AWS account and just you will get a 1 year free tier facility in which you can run one or more server based on the available quota. So here I've just created one such server, which is this particular server, and it's, you can see it's in running state. Now this is the public IP. I'll obviously terminate this server, but for reference I've just created it. So if you see in my terminal, I have this my PEM file, that is the key and private key, private and public key. So here I have to save this particular key in my system just to access this server. So I'll just access this server, nothing too fancy. And for sure, if you are not aware about how to spin up this particular Node.js server, you can just mention them in that in comment. I'll surely will make a video if that's not clear to you. And so see, it's simply the we write SSH connection. We'll create a SSH connection to our server. So this is simply SSH hyphen I, and then dummy.pm, that is my private key. I just renamed it as dummy. Whatever you will name, that name would be shown here. And apart from that, I'll have a default user as Ubuntu. So this is my Ubuntu user and the public URL. So when I'll enter this, you will enter inside the, you will make a SSH connection with the, with your server. So see here, you can see that Ubuntu user and this particular server is set up. Okay. Now see, I'll show you, I'll just go do sudo su just to get the root access. Now once I'll do ls, so this is my same application which I have shown you in VS Code. So see, this is the same application. It has all those files, app.js, db.js. Now we'll discuss about these two files. We have this Docker file and another one is the Docker compose.yml file. So let's move back to the VS Code and I'll explain you what exactly these two files do. So first we'll check this Docker file. Okay, so this Docker file is nothing, just a basic build file which we provide our Docker Compose, or if we don't want to use Docker Compose and we want to create our container ourselves, we use this Docker file. Okay, and here we have written a simple few commands in which we have written this. We want to use node 10, so if we write that in from, so we have different different version of packages or library available on the Docker Hub. So from there we have used node version 10. So we write this thing here, and the working directory is the directory which we take as our main directory inside our Docker container. Once this is done, we'll copy our packet.json file inside our this root in our work directory, and after that we'll want to perform this npm install just to install all the modules. And finally, we want to copy everything inside our container. So this command will do that. And then we'll expose port 3000 of our container so that it can be accessed through the parent machine. And once this is done, we normally, whatever we do in our local while running the node project, npm start, and this will start the our application inside our container, our node application. So npm start is the normal command. If you have any other command, suppose node index.js, you can run that as well. Yeah, now we'll see what exactly does the Docker compose file does. So suppose we have these two services which we are running. One is the Docker application, which is the Docker file which I shown you earlier. So I showed this particular Docker service before. So that is the one service, and another one is the Mongo service which we want to use just to basically run our MongoDB server and just to connect it with our Docker file. So nothing too fancy. Here I have just written all the name of the container, the name of the image. The container name is the container which where we have copied all our code, and we have created the work directory in our Docker file. Here you can see in the Docker file. So this will spin up the container, and this is the name of the container which will be created. So first it will create an image that will be named as Docker image. You can write it any name whichever you want in the Docker container and image both. And then I'll move with the restart. Restart is by default no, okay, but always means that it'll try to restart itself after equal interval of time. So this is the always I have written here and build. Okay, so this is the main command which so dot here means is that it will search for the Docker file. So you should have a Docker file in your parent or the root directory where your Docker Compose file is. Unless it is not present, it'll throw an error. So it require all those information to basically run your or spin up your container by creating an image. So this command is mandatory. Although all the command are mandatory, but this is just to make it figure out where is that Docker file is. So make sure two things: the spelling of the Docker file should be correct because it by default searches for that, and rest it should be in the same root folder where your Docker Compose file is. So try to just put this in your root folder of your project. Now depends upon, so this is a very important key. Suppose I have my Node.js application, but I want it to, it should be depend on MongoDB. Unless until your Mongo is up and running, your this first server, your Node application won't run. It will throw an error that yeah, there's some error with the MongoDB, whatever it could be. So you have to tell it that yeah, it depends on this Mongo server, and then it will create an hierarchy that first it'll start the Mongo server, then it'll move to Docker app. And yeah, so apart from that, this is the port, that whatever port you want to export from your container and what is the actual running port inside your container. So these port is for that, and link is just to link these two services. We use links, and it'll link the Mongo with the Docker app, and just it'll help it running. And same we have done with the our container, Mongo container. So it does nothing, it just simply spin up the Mongo server, and it create an image that is simply named as Mongo, and the container name is also Mongo. You can write it whatever you want, but if you change it here, you have to change it at other place as well, wherever you want to link it. Okay, so yeah, so here you don't want to change it because it will link to this service, but if you want to do it, you can name it whatever you want. That's not a major issue. So this is the persistent volume. So if suppose your server is rest if your container is restarted, it won't delete your DB. So you want a persistent storage in your container. So this will be that storage. And finally the ports. So this is the actual port which you export. So here it will be 127 because we are running it on 27017 and exporting the 27017 as our container's output port so that other container can connect through it. This is the basic file. Now I'll go to my server and I'll just do a ls. So I've already done an ls. So this is the basic file structure. So I'll just clear it and I'll create. I'll what I have to do for running this is docker hyphen compose and up. If you write it up, it will just start your Docker Compose file. Soon I press enter, so it just started creating the build for the Docker file and let it roll for some time. See, so my DB is connected successfully, everything is working fine. Now if I'll go to my browser and I'll do localhost 3000, there is some error. Oh sorry, it won't be a localhost, it would be my instance public IP. So I'll copy this, okay, and I'll do this 3000. See, it's up and running. So this is a basic flow of how to create a compose file for your Docker containers. So this is Docker Compose. The Docker Compose is something which basically, if you want to bind or if you want to run more than spin up more than one container that depends on each other, you can write a Docker Compose file so that maybe in future, when suppose your server goes down, you don't have to manually start all the services by yourself. Just you have to spin up a single file and your all the containers are up and running. So that is just for the ease, but obviously you can do it manually as well, but who wants to do anything manually if the automation is available? So this is the simple tutorial. If you found something that needs more explanation or something you think could be explained more precisely, so you can let me know in the description, or sorry, in the comments. I'll try to cover that. I'll make another video if that solves the purpose. So I guess we'll thank you for watching.